Hi, and welcome to another Unity tutorial. Let's have a look at how we can build and animate some small tanks for a little tank game. First, we have to download the tank constructor. Search for tank constructor in the Unity Asset Store or just follow the link in the description. After download, we have a new folder called tank constructor. Let's have a look inside. It's full of really nice, colorful bitmaps we can use to build our new tank. Let's go for it and create a new tank. Let's begin by adding an empty game object. This will work as a container for all the tank bitmaps. Alright, we now have a really good looking tank, and now we would like to add some animation. Select the right track and go to the animation window. We can now click on create to make our first track animation. It's nice to have all the animations together, so we will make a new folder and call that animations. Save the new animation and call it something like track move. Now we can drag our track animation into the animation window. It's a very simple animation. It's only made by 2 frames, but it works fine for this type of gameplay. Let's have a look at the animation. Whoa, it's way too fast. We have to slow that down. Let's change the frame rate to 10 and have a look again. Looks much better this time. Okay, we now have a nice move animation, but we also need an idle animation when the tank is not moving. So click on create new clip and save it as track idle. This time we only need 1 bitmap because the tank is not moving at all. Alright, now let's switch to the animator window. We have 2 animations, track move and track idle. And track move is the default animation. Now we have to set up some kind of system so we can control the animations from C#. First, we create a new boolean and call it isMoving. Now we can make the transitions. Right click on an animation and select make transition. We can drag the transition to the other animation. We also have to do a transition the other way around. Now we can select a transition and create a condition. So when the isMoving boolean is false, we go to idle. And when it's true, we go to the move animation. In the animator window, we can even test if it's working. Whoa, looks so good. Now we can just copy all the animations to the left tracks as well. Delete the old left tracks and copy the right tracks and rename it to left tracks. Here we go. Let's just reposition the tracks, something like this. And the animation looks fine. Now let's have a look at the scripting. I have made 2 scripts, a track script and a tank script. Let's have a look at the track script. As we can see, it's a very simple script. It's actually just 1 line where we define the animator variable. Now we can add the script to the tracks game objects. When that is done, we can drag the animator component down to the animator variable. Now we have easy access to the animator component from the script. Okay, let's have a look at the tank script. It's actually quite complicated, so we won't go in details here. You can download the whole script from the link in the description. For now, we will just concentrate on the first 6 variables. The first 2 variables are the tracks variables, and the next 4 are the keyboard shortcuts. Now let's drag the tank script up to the tank game object. Now we can just type in the keys we want to control the tank with. In this case, it will be W, S, D, and A. You also have to drag the two tracks game objects into the variables of the script. Okay, let's see how it looks. It's awesome. I can completely control the tank and the animation seems to work fine as well. Now, before we create another tank, it's time to set up some basic collision. Let's start with some box colliders 2D. I think that will do, but we also need a rigid body for the collision to work. Click Add Component and Rigid Body 2D, and we just have to remember to set the gravity to 0. Our first tank is done and we can now copy it and rename it. We will call the next tank for Tank Red. Let's move that to the right. And let's make an awesome red tank. Now we have a really nice red tank and we just have to update the keyboard controls. And we go for the arrow keys and they're just called up, down, right and left. Let's test again. Oh yes, this is so beautiful. We have two independent tanks and the collision detection works fine as well. Okay, we are almost done for today, but before we stop, let's make a really nice tile background. Right click and select 2D object and tile map. Then select window, 2D and tile palette. Create a new palette and rename it to maybe ground. Save it in a new folder, we can call that for just tiles. Now we can just drag our favorite tile into the tile palette and start, we just have to save it, and then start painting. Alrighty, now we have a really nice looking background, but it would be nice to have some shadows as well. This is just a black dot with some blur I added in Photoshop, but I think it will do the trick. Okay, almost done, and then we have to copy it to the red tank as well. Here we go, and now let's test. This is awesome. It looks perfect. That was all for today. See you soon for another Unity tutorial.